It's CBC Kids Book Club.
Hiya! Oh, I'm so glad to see you. And so is my friend and a meowsing author, Phyllis Webstad.
Hi there.
Phyllis wrote a book about how every child matters. In fact, that's the title of the book.
That's right. And Carlene Harvey drew the pictures.
Hmm. Well, what's the story about, Phyllis?
It's a story about how Indigenous people lived on Turtle Island for a long time. We have a beautiful culture. We dance, we sing, and we speak our own languages.
Wow, that sounds really neat.
It is neat, but not everyone thought so. When I was a kid, I was forced to leave my family and go to a place called a residential school, where we weren't allowed to sing our songs, dance our dances, or speak our languages.
That sounds scary.
It was scary. I felt alone and confused. I felt unloved and uncared for. No one explained why I couldn't go home. I felt like I did not matter.
Oh, but you do matter, Phyllis.
I know that now. After 300 sleeps, I finally went home. For a long time, I believed I did not matter, and I was not the only one. Today, I know that this is not true. Now I know I have the right to walk on this earth and breathe this air as much as anyone else. Now I know that I matter.
Oh, I'm so glad you got to go home, Phyllis. And I hope no one ever has to go to a terrible place like that ever again.
I hope so too. If you're a survivor of a residential school, you matter. If you're a family member of a survivor, you matter. And all the children who didn't make it home matter. Every child matters in the past, the present, and the future.
Phyllis, you matter to me. Can I give you a hug?
I would love that, Cottonball.